You know, random rooster, even though I am from the underwater realm, as you well know, sometimes I can't help myself, and I poke my head out of the water, and I look up at the stars. And with that, we begin Look Up. Ever heard of Henrietta Leavitt? You haven't? The pioneering woman astronomer? You haven't? You know why you haven't. Her life was a little bit mysterious. A brilliant scientific mind in an era when women weren't really allowed to pursue scientific studies in a big way. That's so wrong. Well, you know, things were different back then. Women didn't have equal rights. So even though she was prevented from doing everything she dreamed of doing, guess what, Green Bear?
What?
She still managed to make some massive discoveries. And that's why we're reading her book today.
Cool. I can't wait to learn about this. What's your name again?
Henrietta Leavitt.
Henrietta. I kind of like that name. It sounds smart.
It does sound smart, doesn't it? Night after night, Henrietta sat on her front porch, there she is, gazing up at the stars. How high is the sky? Ever stop to think about that? Huh, that's a good question. Well, she wanted to know everything about the wonderful bigness of all she saw. The more she looked up, the bigger the sky seemed to get. It seemed endless. Now, you may think that these are just theoretical questions, but these are real questions that scientific people ask themselves. Now, on cloudless evenings, she found the Big Dipper inching its slow, glittering track across the night sky. She drew an imaginary line from the Dipper's pan. See, it leads to the North Star. Sometimes she felt the stars were trying to speak, to tell her what they knew. Star Whisperer. Well, when Henrietta was a young woman, almost all the astronomy teachers and students were, there you see, men. In an astronomy class, she was one of the very few women students. But Henrietta wanted to follow what she loved wherever it took her. And most of all, she loved the vast distances, light years, the distance that can travel in 1 year, about 6 trillion miles.
Did you say trillion?
Trillion miles.
Whoa. You're blowing my mind, storyteller.
Well, that's what we do around here at KidTime StoryTime. And many stars were light years away. I mean, think of it. Amazing. Trillions of miles away. Well, after graduating, Henrietta worked in an observatory. Have you seen one of those before? They're very distinctive looking. So pretty. In the observatory was a giant telescope. We're not talking a little bitty telescope like you see the pirates use. We're talking a big, super-sized one for the stars. Now, even so, Henrietta, even though she was working in this observatory, rarely had a chance to gaze through it to see the stars up close.
Is this all because she's a girl?
Probably.
Oh, man, that's so unfair.
I know. Thank goodness things have improved. But it makes her accomplishments all the more remarkable because they didn't make it easy. Instead, Henrietta was working in a small room alongside the other scientific women. The hours were long, and the pay was only 30 cents an hour. 30 cents an hour! No, don't ever complain about your allowance after you hear that. The women who worked there were human computers. Their job was to record and measure and calculate. Now, these women were expected to work, not think. Ha ha ha! But Henrietta, she had other ideas.
Wait.
Oh, yes, Jess Green Bear?
She was a computer? You're telling me that her brain was a computer? Like a computer?
Yeah, it was like a computer. She was that good with calculations that she could do it all in her head as opposed to using computers because, as well, you know, what do you know?
There weren't computers yet, were there?
Not yet. Okay. Didn't she have a mind? She asked herself, and couldn't she use it? She's not just going to calculate. She can think for herself, right? So each day, she peered through a magnifying glass right here to measure the tiny star dots on photographs of the previous night's sky. Now, on the photographs, the stars resembled little bits of dust. That's all it looks like in the photo. But what could these tiny dots tell her? What were they saying? Obviously, our girl here is looking for clues to the universe. Henrietta kept studying in her spare time. She read about the lives of great astronomers. She loved to repeat to herself her favorite sky words. Isn't that great? Sky words. Words like asteroids, cosmic dust, and eclipse. Oh, so poetic and vast. Oh, and here's a picture of some of the great astronomers that she was reading about. Copernicus, Galileo. Have you heard those names before? You could read about them too, just like she did. At work, Henrietta looked and looked and looked until her eyes blurred. When she closed her eyes, she could still see the stars and the little dots dancing across the insides of her eyelids. Did you ever do that? Close your eyes and see the stars? If you're an astronomer, maybe you do. Day after day, there were new photographs of stars to look at. Day after day, Henrietta returned to the small, stuffy room, and together with the other women, workers, they studied the photographs. She measured, she took notes, and looked, and looked, and looked, and slowly, she began to see tiny differences between the star dots. So she's starting to interpret the information. But boy, it takes persistence, doesn't it? She especially studied a group of stars that glowed and dimmed, then glowed again, like so. Got it? Yeah, I thought so. Well, she even discovered some blinking stars. Beep, 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 beep. They may not have actually had made that sound, but I'm adding it. Beep, 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 beep. She discovered these blinking stars that no one had ever discovered before, but there was still more to do. So patiently, Henrietta worked on. She's not going to stop at one discovery, is she? No, we're not going to stop. Can't stop, won't stop. She recorded the number of nights it took for each blinking star to go from dim to bright, basically from off to on. One day, she realized something. Some very bright stars, bing, 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 blinked more slowly than the less bright stars. Now, what could this mean? Because everything means something, right? Everything's a clue. She's like a sky detective here. Now, what could this mean? She began to keep a careful chart. And then suddenly, ba, 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 Henrietta saw a pattern. A slow blink time meant that a star contained lots of light or power or brightness. And if the blink time was even slower, the star contained even more light. Now, by measuring the time it took for a star to go from off to on, one could tell the true brightness of any blinking star in the sky, even if it was just a faint speck far, 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 far away. Well, the head astronomer at the observatory was amazed. And well, he should be. When astronomers know the true brightness of a star, you see, it helps them figure out how far the star is from the Earth. Henrietta was onto something, a breakthrough. Yes, I am an astronomer. Henrietta published her chart in a magazine. She was proving that the smallest observation, the tiniest discovery, often leads to something very important.
Yes, yes, because small things are very important, aren't they, storyteller?
Indeed, little green bear, they are very important.
I knew it, I knew it.
Oh, look at the light changing on us, huh? Shall we go on? Can you still see? Yeah, I think you can still see, right? All right. Yeah, the light is crazy sometimes around here. Around this time, now most people thought that the Milky Way, the galaxy containing the Earth, made up the whole universe. That, you know, Milky Way, there was one universe, that's it. But people didn't think that anymore. Henrietta's chart helped astronomers measure distances much farther away. First, the Milky Way itself was found to stretch out farther than anyone thought. Next, astronomers discovered even more galaxies, many of them. The universe was far more vast than anyone had ever dreamed. And why? Because the stars had spoken to Henrietta. But I would like to point out that Henrietta was listening too, wasn't she? It's not good enough to have people talk to you. You gotta listen to what they're saying. All right, can still see, okay, right? Okay. Still, Henrietta, she's not done discovering. She keeps working. One winter night, she's there in her nice coat, looking up at the stars as usual. She's walking home from the observatory and she stops. The sky was cold and very clear, like it can be on a very cold night. Suddenly, she remembered from her childhood long, long ago when she had gazed up from her parents' front porch. Yes, it is the same beautiful and mysterious sky, but now it is so much bigger. Henrietta smiled. Her mind, roamed. She dreamed. She whispered to herself again. How high? How high is the sky? Look at that beautiful, beautiful picture. Nice job. That is beautiful. Raul Colon, beautiful drawings. And Bob Burleigh wrote this book. He chatted with me online. He loved that we were going to read this for Kid Time Story Time. Why? Because Henrietta Leavitt, she's a one of a kind. She was really a pioneering woman doing things that nobody did back in the day. Do you want to see her picture? It's very tiny. Here, I'll close up for you right there. See her a little bit better? That's the real Henrietta Swan Leavitt, born on the 4th of July, 1868. That's a long time ago. And actually, her life is a little bit of a mystery since, you know, she was a lady. They didn't really follow her life all that closely. But she worked at the Harvard College Observatory in Cambridge, Massachusetts. That's the observatory that you saw in the book. She was acting like a human computer. And those stars that you saw that she talked about, that they would turn off and on and be faster and slower, those are called Cepheid variable stars because their light varies or glows and fades and had a fixed pattern to their changes. So, as you see, because of the discoveries that Henrietta made, the astronomers, using other facts and formulas that were coming in, were able to measure these great distances in the universe. One fellow even wanted to give her the Nobel Prize, but he didn't know Henrietta had already died. And you actually can't get a Nobel Prize posthumously. That's the fancy word for after you die. But that was a story of an amazing pioneering woman called Henrietta Leavitt that maybe might inspire you to look up at the stars. What do you think?
Well, you know, I always have loved to look at the stars, and now I really appreciate that there are people, big important-brained people like Henrietta and others.
Yes, yes, Fuchsia Fish,
who look up and tell us what's happening up there, and calculate and let us know that there's so much more there than even our little eyes can see. Although, really, they say that my eyes are not that small.
No, they are. They're pretty big, but they're no telescope.
That's true. Bloop, 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 bloop. You know?
Yeah, a green bear, you're back.
Well, I really enjoyed the story.
Good. Did you learn something from it?
Yeah. I learned that a brain could be a computer.
Yeah, that's true.
That ladies used to not be able to do the big important work in science before, but now they can.
Exactly.
That, and of course, that boys and girls could do science. I mean, really, I don't know why they thought that girls couldn't do science. I have girls in my class that do science with me, too. And my science partner was this girl. And we did this thing. And there was a frog. But I really don't want to go into it. But she was smart, you know, and I like working with her. So I think that everybody should look up and do whatever their brain tells them to do.
I think that you are right on the money.
Hey, thank you, storyteller. Oh, and see you next time, kid.
Yeah, see you next time, kid. And remember, we here at Kid Time Storytime always, always look up in every way we can. See you next time.